When you need to get deep into Windows, just do what the PC tinkerers and IT pros already do, which is to use the command prompt. Now, just to be clear, the command prompt is not the DOS prompt, which is long gone, but it looks a lot like it because you're typing text onto this dark little screen. Here's how to get to it. Go to the Start button and right-click it, and scroll up, and you'll see the command prompt option right here. Now, the other thing you're going to see right underneath it is an option called Command Prompt Admin. We're not going to need it for the commands that I'm going to show you, but sometimes if you need to get really, really deep into your PC, you're going to need the Command Prompt Admin option. And you'll know, because you'll try a command and you'll get something like System Error 5, Access Denied. And that's when you change to admin mode and try it again. So we're going to go into regular Command Prompt. And we're going to show you the first command that everyone should know, which is ipconfig. When you type this, you will get all the internet connection details for your computer. And say you're looking for like the IP address of your router, here it is right here in default gateway. Now here's another neat internet trick. If your internet connection is acting wonky, all you have to do is come here and type ping. And then the URL of any common website that you know will be on all the time. And what it's going to do is it's going to send a bunch of data packets to that website. And if all the packets are sent and received just fine, then you know that your internet connection is not the problem. Now, here is one of my favorite commands because it's kind of existential. It's called Who Am I? And if you type that, it'll tell you the domain name and the username that's currently active on the PC. And you can add a bunch of parameters to get more information or do what I'm about to do, which is whoami/all. And that will give you the whole laundry list of user settings, including my privileges and my email addresses and all that. Now, that's just a very small sampling of what you can do at the command prompt. To get a full list, go to Microsoft's website and search on command line reference. Now, there's just one more thing to know. When Microsoft upgrades Windows 10 to the Creator's Update, it's going to replace Command Prompt with a new shell called PowerShell. Now, there's nothing wrong with that one, but if you like Command Prompt, don't worry, you can go into Settings and replace that as your default. Now, if you have any other favorite commands, let us know about them at answer@pcworld.com.